One of the most significant factors in the absence of lament in especially the American and Western church is a very deeply rooted sense of triumphalism and exceptionalism that we find ourselves expressing in both the American church and in American society. If we believe that we are an exceptional people and a people that are specially favored by God over all other people, then we should just continue to be victorious and triumphant and successful. The reality in a fallen world, a broken world, that's not the way life works. There are places where we struggle, we experience pain, we experience suffering. So sometimes our worship life can be an analgesic that covers up wounds. We're not being honest. We're not being truthful. We're not speaking truth to God nor to each other. And so part of the appeal and the need for lament is to say, we are missing this in our life. Our gospel, our understanding of who God is incomplete unless we know that there is lament along with celebration, that there is suffering along with triumph. And there's a list that's published by the CCLI company that publishes the top most popular contemporary worship songs that are sung in the United States. And I would say that maybe five to 10 out of the top 100 songs, contemporary worship songs, would be lament psalms or lament songs. If you look at a typical hymnal, 85% of our hymns are more likely to be hymns about triumph and victory. And only about 15% of our hymns are likely to be hymns about lament and suffering. So what we're seeing is a loss of discipline. We're seeing something that in the scriptures we see over and over again. People who suffer, who are able to cry out in their worship to God in lament. But one of the ways that lament operates, especially in a corporate setting, is to give voice to the voiceless or give voice to those who have been victims of injustice, who have been oppressed by the powers of the world. And they have nowhere else to turn except to God. And so when the enemy is attacking, when there is injustice in the streets, when there's poverty and hunger, and there's all sorts of things that God did not intend for our world, our recourse is lament. Our recourse is to turn to God and to cry out to Him in lament. So when lament is lost as a discipline in our church life, what we're doing is we're silencing those whose voices we need to hear. So I think what lament does is it opens the door to another narrative, another story, another point of view, another experience in history that says we can hear these stories and our lives will be better, our lives will be transformed, we will know more about God. So one of the things we had to do was we introduced stories and experiences that indicated that there is another world that is out there. We would do significant outreach into our community. We were in a community in Cambridge that had a lot of intellectuals and a lot of students from these top-notch schools, but it was also an inner-city neighborhood. It was also an urban neighborhood. And the intersection of these communities, where not only could the college students work with at-risk children, but also actually learn from the spiritual depth and wisdom of their parents in that community. So it was a wonderful mutual learning experience. And we can go and we can serve the senior citizens at an inner-city nursing home. And yes, we could serve them by being with them and spending time with them, but they share their wisdom in their vulnerability being in a nursing home. So we need to introduce that into our worship life. We need to make sure lament is found in our worship life, but it also has to be a lifestyle. It also has to be worship that continues beyond the walls of the church.